Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I want to show you the Earth Battery. Now, the Earth Battery really sucks, but it was a cool idea. And basically, I made a long video. It's about 50 minutes long, testing out the voltage of each things I tried. The Earth Battery really is not good to survive or do any type of thing except for a science project or maybe a bushcrafter would make one for maybe a woodcraft project with an Earth Battery. You're ready to watch a long 50 minute video about the Earth Battery and the contents. But I'm warning you now, when the next woof, starts that long video. You don't have to watch it because I'm going to sum it up all right here in this one couple minute video. Now, if you want to watch what I did, go ahead. Because I'm going to spit a lot of numbers out for each item and then show you what I use for each cell. Cell is these called these things. That's a cell. Basically, a battery. It can charge a very small light, depending on the mud I use. It can charge a solar light. If I had 8 cells, it should crank up a 3 solar light. Can I use this in a survival situation? If I had 8 of these. This was giving me 1.6, 1.6, 1.6, 1.6, 1.6. Add them all together, gave me almost like 96 volts. Not even that. That's not even a volt. I tried different methods. I did different things. I tried different items. You can watch that video. It's coming up next. Like I said, when the wolf howls, you have a choice to watch and complete and watch that video. It'd be a little fuzzy, but oh, it's okay. You can still understand what I'm saying. I'm going to give you a bunch of numbers and a bunch of things for each thing I tried. I mean, this probably could work in a survival situation, but I only gave it. There's 5 numbers, but I took only 1 number and gave it a percentage of this working as a survival tool. I gave it a 5% chance being a survival tool. Lighting a bitty light, which would not help you at all. Alright, I'm Ranger Kooky. I hope you enjoy this like hour-long video. Remember, you don't have to watch it because I summed it up with this small video, letting you know it's would not be a good survival tool. I mean, here it is again. What you want to do is a piece of copper and some clay. A zinc rod connected to a copper rod to a zinc rod. Basically, this is your plus and this is your negative. Then you hook. I tried to recharge this battery, but I bet you I need all kinds of little cells. I'm not an electronic person or into electronic stuff, but there's someone out there. What do you viewers know about electronics? And hey, if I tell you what, I'm ready to call this, that's it. This is it. This is the last part you hear about the Earth Battery, but it does work. I took this copper rod and this rod and stick it into the ground, I will get at least 1.6 volts. Or not even a volt, a megavolt. You know, a little bitty thing. But you can't plug them all into the ground. It will short them out, so you have to put them in buckets like this. Now, I did research about longer pipes into the ground or longer dirt or different types of dirt, but there is dirt, sand, dirt, clay, dirt, sand, mud, clay. I tried different things. That's going to be in the next video you're ready to watch. That's if you watch it. You do not have to watch it. It's not about bushcrafting or, but it might be in a survival situation where you can use an Earth Battery. Trust me, I got a little light going. You'll see it in that video. If I had more, according to my knowledge, if I had 8 of these, I should got at least a solar light lit up. That'd be good to have in an emergency situation, but don't know how long it lasts. I tested these and it went to the negatives. It went like the energy is gone out of them, even though it's made out of dirt. All right, well, I hope you enjoy the next video. This video is about the Earth batteries, what I perceive from them. And if any of my viewers say, hey, Ranger Kooky, I believe this will work if you try this and you send me that part to try it, I'll be happy to do it. Right there, that cost me $30. That's that little part and some wire. $30. Is it worth it? No, it's not worth it. I try to charge a battery with the Earth battery. No good. I tried different things with the Earth battery. No good. Only thing it's good for is to light three of those little solar lights, and it barely did that. I lit this little bitty light, and it takes like three VR batteries. So I'm just going to sum this video up, and guess what? The can worm is next. I'm ready to build the can worm. All this junk I got here, all these cans, different sizes. And see if the can worm works. All right, I know that's going to be a thumbs up on that one. The Earth batteries, yeah, that's a killer there. I hope I can return those pipes so I can get my money back. Good luck on that. Kind of dirty now. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky. I hope you enjoy that video is coming up. Men of the Wolf Speak, you know, is going to be the long 50 minute or 55 minutes. I didn't cut nothing out. I left it alone because you need every little bit of information. I talked to the whole thing. So I hope you enjoy it. If you don't, just say, oh, I don't enjoy it. Just stop where you're at right now. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky, and there's the next video. Ooh. I'm Ranger Kooky, and today is the Earth battery test. I'm going to be using two cameras. I'm going to see if I can splice them all together. So make a story for you. What is the Earth battery? The Earth battery is based on dirt and other items that you can use to create your own battery. Yes, using dirt can make your own battery. And I'm here to make a test. We're going to do a test with everything that people throw away. Let's take a look at some of the stuff. This is coffee grounds, lemon peels, tea leaves from tea, bread. I got my old bread and the ends of bread that people usually throw away. And over here, I got eggshells. I have lemon juice. I have vinegar. I have salt. And I have some type of very high corrosive acid. Now, what you want to do, you need a copper cell and a zinc. And believe it or not, this creates electricity. Now, if you notice, there's water in this container, nothing but water. I'll show you. I'm going to show you one camera. Now I have an empty tube of brass. I'm sorry, copper. And a piece of zinc. I'm going to place that in the water like so. Now I have the same thing. I have zinc and a copper. You notice there's nothing in it. Now I'm going to test it just to show that, hey, I'm not getting no type of electricity off of these items. All right. My plus is always good with the copper and zinc. Damn, I'm getting a reading. I got a reading of 2. That's weird. Is it wet? I'm getting a reading of 3, just touching these two. So somehow, the water, yeah, there's a little water vacuum, but I should get a 1.4 when it's in water. Now this is like well water. 1.4. I got 1.4 on my little thing here. And that's in normal water with minerals. What? All right. Now, I tested different items. I tested coffee. I'm going to put a rod in. This is tea. And a rod into the other side. And give it a few minutes. Then I'm going to do the same thing with the coffee. I'm going to put another rod into it. It's basically dirt. I can just grab some dirt and use the same thing. I'm going to do that in a few minutes. Now, I got bread. How can we test bread without no liquid? So I guess we have to crush it all up. Crush that bread all in the pieces. And I'm wondering if bread has an acetone in it. Tea, coffee has acid in it. So what I'm going to do is chop all this up. Alright, back where I was. I forgot where I was. Look up a little bit. There you go. Alright. Now I was breaking up this bread to see if I can make a batch of soup or something. Because people throw away bread. Let's make a battery out of it if we can. Because if I could put a copper and a zinc in a cup and maybe add some water to it and make a slush puppy out of it, I should maybe get a extra vote out of this. So what happens if I find out if I put that? Now I got some sand over here and I'm going to try plain, then I can add the water to it. So I need to add my copper rod and my thing. And over here, the same thing again in the bread. Now, maybe the bread gives me an extra boost, but believe it or not, this should give me, like I said, a 1.4 amp. Oh, it's 1.5, so I guess I let it sit for a while. 1.5. Okay, now this is tea leaves. We'll see what it gave me. 1.3. And coffee, 1.2. So what I'm going to do is add water to both of these. Because I had a better reading when I was doing this at work, trying different stuff that we have that we throw away all the time. And see, give that time to sit. And let's try the bread. 1.3, 0.4. 1.3, and the sand, 1.2. Alright, let's pack that in. There you go. Now, I heard clay does a better job, but we're going to find out about that later. And down below, I got buckets of more value. I got more bread. I have, it's all soggy, and I got the coffee, tea, and eggshells, which I forgot to put up here. So what I'm going to do is take this container and crush the eggshells up. Because we're always throwing eggshells, we have breakfast, so I wonder if this will give me a high calcium or a very high acetone in my water. Acid's the key to the plan of this. The earth battery has to have some type of acid. Now I wonder if I can mix it up with different chemicals and different stuff to make me a battery. All right. Now, I know I need water, so I'm just going to leave this water in this one cup and pour my eggshells in there. All right, it's all my eggshells, so I can't do a test if I have more eggshell. And that goes right here. And maybe some more water. And I got lemons. So lemons are acid. I'm gonna put enough water to go to the top. And we got normal water, which is here. We got tea leaves. We're gonna let add more. Coffee's good. The bread is sop. The sand is not sop, but I'm gonna do a test before and after and see what you think. All right, let's do a test. Let's do coffee. Coffee is giving me 1.2. Gave me 5 last night. I wonder if it's because it's hot. Okay, see, putting it in here gives me a reading of 6. Okay, touch this. This is tea. It's 1.4. Regular water. Make sure the pipes are not touching. This thing's going crazy. Yeah, maybe I need to clean my spikes. All right. It's giving me 1.1. All right, we'll move these to the eggshells. Give it time to sit. All right, now we're going to the bread. See what it gives me. A 1.4 and it's sand dry. Is 1.4, so I'm going to add water to the sand. Give it a few minutes to soak. All right, now let's see what the eggs are giving me. 1.3. When this came out hot, fresh and hot, it was giving me 1.5. Now it's giving me a whole different number. All right, let's try the coffee again. 1.3. The tea leaves, 1.4. The eggshells, maybe I have to let it sit for a while, 1.3. Bread, 1.3. And sand, 1.4. So believe it or not, I made a little battery cell in each one of these cups. I should have another one. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 5. Now, I linked them all together, and I ran this little bitty light. It just trickled. But I turned this light on with a couple of batteries that I created like this. Now, maybe I got too much water, and the water is overriding the coffee. So let's dump some of that water. Oh, got rid of some, because that's how I tested it. It was dry, kind of wet. Let's see. Okay, plus and negative. Got a negative reading on the scale. All right. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and dump some of the water out the tea. Because it's kind of weird. I got a 1.5 when I was at work. Maybe it was hot. All right, let's do another test. 1.4. Coffee. 1.4. Eggshell been sitting there a while. Got water plus eggshell. We'll see what he got. 1.3. Bread, 1.4, between 4 and 3, sand, 1.5, between 1.4, 1.5, see how high that is? All right, now, the other test, pure dirt. I got some dirt over here, follow me real quick. We're going to dig in one of my buckets here. There you go, plain dirt. Grab a empty cup. Here's an empty cup. Get some dirt. Now, I heard the clay is the best item because it got minerals in it. And let's take out the rod with the bread and give it a rinse. Put it in the... Now, if I'm not mistaken, this is supposed to be wet. Let's see what it's giving me this wide dry. 1.3. See? One. Watch again. 1.3. Alright, let's see what happens if I wet it. Yeah, that's too much. Basically, just want the dirt to be wet, not the rods. So I have to go get some dirt. Looks like the earthberry can be a success if I can get it high enough to charge or link them all together. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I could take this. Watch this. Take these two pieces. Find it anywhere in the ground. Here, here's a nice soft spot. And I should be able to shove this in the ground. Now, I'm going to take the copper's always plus, and the other steel is the negative. 1.7. That's high. But if I put another set here, it would draw out that. It would give me another reading, and it will be lower. Let's find out. Let's do a test. That's what we're here for. I test stuff though, so you don't have to. Now, if I'm not mistaken, if I put supposed to be copper and zinc, like so. Now I noticed further they are, less power they get. Oh shit, 1.6. All right, let's go here to here. Oops, wrong way. 1.7, it's closer. So what happens? What happens is we link them together. I think that's where the flaw is, it drowns it out. All right, so I got my roach clips. Homemade, of course. Got two of them. So basically I have to link my negative to my positive, and my positive to my negative. Then I need another roach clip. Let's see. And I need, nope, I don't need nothing else. Should be it. I think I got this wrong. I think it's supposed to be one here, one there. So put it on my negative to my positive. Now I should have a big ass reading. That should be right. Negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Zero. Nothing. Dead. Dead in the water. Gone. No energy. All right, let's try these two. Again, dead. Nothing. I ground them out. You're seeing right now, this. You, some of y'all know what this is, so you know I'm getting juice. Now I'm not getting no juice whatsoever. Never copper is plus, and the other rod is negative. Look, no juice. It went into the negative. So let's unhook my roach clips and do it again. Now I can do a copper and negative. I should have got a reading. Look, I got 1.6. If I went to copper to copper, nothing. Negative to negative, nothing. But if I went to copper to negative, I should get a reading, which you see. I got 1.6. That's really high. That's what I want. I want a 1.6. Or if I went to this copper to this one, I should get a 0.2. 1.6. These two. 1.6. This copper to this one. 1.6. But if I linked them together, I would get a negative result because it's all grounded out. So when I had them in the cups, it was all each individual plus and negative. Most people know what this thing is, so you see I'm not cheating. There's no batteries in this thing. You see the negative and positive. Let's wash them. All right, now let's knock out some of this water here. I think that was drowning out my positive and negative research. Okay, let's. Wash my little tinsels. Let's put it back. Let's put that in the toast. Put this here and here. Now I should get a good reading on all of these. Maybe a different different thing. Okay, let's move you down so you can see. That's 1.4 in sand. Toast. 1.4 again. Darn. All right, tea. 1.4. Damn. Clay. 1.4. I had a 1.6 with all this stuff before. Now it's like, and coffee, 1.4. So 1.4. Oh, water. I'm going to do a test with water. Oh, I'm going to do HL again since it's been sitting. I'm going to get my water, wash this, and try my water again. Basically, I'm trying to make a battery cell. With each individual machine, this is a battery cell now. So I want to make a battery cell for each one. I'm sorry, my other cameras give me AWOL, so you're only going to see one camera. All right, water. This is regular tap water out my well. It's giving me another reading. It was giving me 1.4, 1.3. And I think if I let it sit there and let that water magnetize whatever it's doing, I bet you I get a better reading. All right, let's try the eggs again. 1.3. So I got a negative. All right, chemicals. What can you do with chemicals? Let's try those out. I have salt water. Now, we got water. Salt's supposed to make this battery go up, but every time I use salt, it goes down. There we go. I'm gonna let that sit there, stir it up a little bit, try not to let them touch one another. And the pulse rate of the battery, I can touch this all day, it will not shock me. It's AC or even lower than that, so none of this is gonna hurt me or kill me. So here we go. Here's a night of test we can do. Let's pour this in a bucket. Clean our tools. Look up some. Wash our bucket with eggshell. Because it looks like the eggshell's not doing us any good. So we can just get rid of the eggshell and pour the coffee out. We're going to do a test with the other stuff now. All right, now we're going to try lemon juice. Lemon juice. All right, let's do a test with the bread. Let's see where it's at. So right now, almost all these items are giving me 1.4. I think it's the water. It's the extra stuff is not helping. So the eggshell is not doing its job. So we can just can this into our woods and make our trees grow. That's weird. So that's good for the environment. So we can throw that right out in the woods. It's not going to kill my woods. All right, let's try vinegar in this cup. We got new item. We got the salt water. We have the lemon juice. Now we're going to use distilled white vinegar. All right. And we're going to get rid of our bread because it's not working. So what I'm going to do is just put in a bigger bucket of bread and see if a bigger bucket with bread works. And wash my cup. Now, see what I'm doing? Let's say I can make batteries for each one of these items. I just stick a hole, put a hole in the cup on top of the bucket, and put rods in it. That'd be my battery cell. All right, this one is going to be the very dangerous, corrosive acetone crap. I'm going to be careful, open it. Because if this gets on me, I'm running to the shower or the water. And there you go. I'm going to try to let it all in. Because we need probably every drop. Alright, now I'll go ahead and put my new rods in the acid. And we'll take out the tea and put it into my vinegar. I'm sorry, what is that? Lemon juice. I'm going to let them sit there for a few seconds. They gain probably some type of energy because what happens, the zinc and the copper react to one another and creates electrical stimuli, whatever you want to call it, and makes a little electric. All right, test the thing. Is that working? Let's put it in lemon juice. Boop. Okay, see, went up to 6, so lemon juice might work. All right. Let's try the salt water now. Remember, copper is always going to be the plus, and negative is going to be the opposite metal. You can use aluminum. That's another test I have to do. 1.2. So salt water sucks. All right. Let's try the lemon juice. Oh, 1.7. Hey, let's get that close so you can see. So the lemon juice, 1.6. All right, we have one more test. It's the acid. It's been sitting there for a while. Let's take a look. Let's see what happens. It's touching in there, so I have to move it away. I tried Darn. I tried different types of things, and it's giving me, there we go. Damn, a negative. So whatever this is, it's not going to do me any good to have. This acid is really bad. All right, let's see if I can put this in a cleaning solution. Just a bucket of water. All right, let's try the lemon juice one more time. Lemon juice. Oh, it's touching on her. See, 1.5 for lemon juice. Salt water, again. Damn. It looks like it went even lower. All right. Mud. 1.5. 1.4. 1.5. All right. So now, what can we do? What happens if we have more? Would that help us out? If we had more tea, more stuff to do our tests? Let's find out. Would a bigger rod help? But right now, you have to find out what works, what don't work. What doesn't work and what does work is the question. All right, regular water here. We got sand over here. Let's clean out another tool. And I think it's too much water. So let's dump some of that water. All right. Let's try the lemon. Let's give me 2. That's just a real lemon. Lemon juice is giving me another number. All right, let's do our test again. This is mud. Oops, plus one. 1.5. That's good. Salt water. Salt water. Shit, it even went lower. Okay, tap water. It's touching. Okay, let's do it again. .6 regular tap water. All right, sand. Whoops, I'll change it around. 1.5. And once again, lemon juice. Can't let them touch in the water. It will drown out the electrical current. All right, lemon juice one more time. Damn, touching again. 1.4. So my conclusion, the tap water is giving me the best number there, 1.5. Oh yeah, I think the lemon juice was giving me good juice. Oh, not no more. Let's see, let's try it this way. Salt water. Damn, it's like killing it. It's going lower and lower. So salt water is out the question. All right, and we did mud earlier over there in the ground. It was 1.6. Let's see what it gives me over here. 1.5. Look at that. 1.5. So if I make my battery out of mud and tap water, I'm going to get better results. But here's the question. Does more help out? We got a whole bucket of tea, coffee, and bread. We already noticed bread don't help worth a damn. So we got rid of bread. So I'm gonna feed my birds some stale bread that I get from my gerb. The birdies gonna love this. Come watch the birdies. And I got a little table. I set all the food on this table and look through the window and watch the birds eat. It's a little sloggy. He's soggy bread, but them birds will eat it later. Once that bread dries up, it just be munchy, crunchy, tasty, stale bread. Now I got a bucket I gotta clean. All right, I got another bucket I gotta clean right here. I'm sorry. Oh, I'm not even gonna say I'm proud. Yep. Cut. Cut that up. All right, my other camera's giving me hell today. Got some more eggshells and some bread. Throw that to the birds. Hey, shells over here. All right, now we need to get our battery going. All right, let's find out about this first. Now we know the salt is doing nothing. So let's rinse that salt off. The salt is killing our electrical system. Okay, now we got coffee in a bigger pot, and I got some lead. I forgot to do the test with lead. If I only have to do a test one time with lead, and that's giving me 1.6, so it's higher now. Son of a bitch. Okay, let's try tea once more. See what it gives us. It's a little dry, but it's moist. Let's mix it all up. Put the copper in the thing. Do a test. 1.6. So it's higher now, but it's drier. So this will be what I need. A 1.6 will help. That 1 point helps out. All right, we're done with our little electrical machine here because we did our test. Now we have to make our batteries. How are we going to make our batteries? Okay, we know lemon juice. Salt water was going down. Okay, let's wash all around. All right, the mud was doing good. The salt water, the lemon juice, no good. Whee! hate the waste, but... Alright, we're going to wash our cups. Okay, we got washed cups, got tap water, we got some very corrosive stuff that we can't use. I don't think I even can use the cup. And we got mud, sand. Alright, let's put... I'm missing a cell? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's it. Alright, now we're going to make a cell. But first, I need to stop you and get a little light bulb. Alright, I took all the ingredients out and put mud, clay, sand. And I think my main ingredients is water in each one. What I'm going to do is try to charge this little light over here. I'm doing tests to see if I can get it lit. Just to show you, I've got a battery here. I'm going to take this wire and this wire here. This is my negative. And this is my plus, and the light should come on. Alright, so let's put my negative back onto my negative. And I probably have to run wires to each one of these to make it work. But I'm going to try to touch each one and see if it works this way, which I doubt. So I'm going to get Velcro strips, maybe. Let's do a test. Let's see what happens. All right, clay. This one's 7. Gotta let, this is 1.4. 1.6, because the water's been sitting around. 1.6. 1.56. Okay, what I'm gonna do, I'll be right back. I'm gonna get, all right. My light is on. I have the battery cell. I connected one copper to a zinc, to a copper to a zinc, copper to a zinc, and so forth. And I got this little light to go on. There's no batteries in this system. I got my fingers on here, and I turn on that little light right there. And I'm using sand. Clay dirt. All right. There we go. All right. I'm going to collude this, the Earth battery. There's no batteries in none of these containers. I tried to turn on a, what you call this, you son of a bitch, you. All right, I tried to turn on one of these solar power lights. It did not work, but I could turn on this light. Let's see, plus and minus. See the little light? I got it on. I turned this little bitty light on by using Earth batteries. I hope you enjoy my video. I want to show you the power with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cells. This is the plus. And this is where I'm getting. Almost 9 little volts, whatever that is, the 200V, 8.4 by these Earth batteries. Now, I noticed the Earth batteries works way better than the water batteries because I was getting, I think, 1.6 out of each cell, 1.4, 1.7, Why this one's, oh, one po- between 1 and 0, and the sandy one, oh, damn it, 1.5, and this clay one, 1.6. This includes the earth battery cells. So if I had more copper and zinc pipe, copper, and more of these, I probably can run this light here that needs one 4-point-something volts, and I'm only getting a half a volt. So I hope you enjoy the earth batteries. You can make earth batteries with these little boats. And this thing here. But you need a lot of wire to do so. A lot of wire or copper piping. You put dirt in all these little tubes. And you take a little piece of wire and you tie it there. And go into the next cell. And you do this all through the cells, and you make a earth battery using 8 crates and mud, a little copper piping and zinc. I bought this at Home Depot. You can probably find bigger pipes. I don't know if the longer pipes would make a better connection or more juice. So I'm not going to do that test, because this test cost me almost $30 to do and complete. You see my results with this little tester. I had a couple problems, but I just tied each one of these with no string. I just put the pipe. You should have gone. All right. I just put the pipes together with bread tweezers instead of tying them up with alligator clamps. I was trying to get this light to go on, but the battery cell are too weak. Would I can use this in a survival situation? Probably not. Charging a battery? I do not know this would charge a battery. I could try to hook these two up and see if I could charge this battery. What I'm gonna do, a test. I'm gonna leave this right out here. I'm gonna put this on the ground and see if I can charge this little battery here. I'm getting almost 9-point-something. And when I test the thing, how much juice this is giving me is, this thing's giving me a juice about 4-point-something. So I wonder if I could charge one of these little batteries higher. Let's do a test. Here's a real chargeable battery. I can do a test. We're going to do a scan with this little thing here. All right, this thing says 1.3. So if I wonder, if I plug these two up, would I get more juice to this battery later on through the day? So right now I'm charging this battery very, very slowly, and I wonder how long it would take to charge it. So I want to see what I can do to make this a chargeable thing. Leave these out, but I'm picking up my table and see what happens. All right, I'm going to include this. Can we use this as a chargeable battery cell? Maybe if I had more cells, maybe. Maybe it could charge a big battery for my flashlights if I need a flashlight. If not, we'll be screwed out in the middle of the woods with dead batteries, unless I have some way to charge it. But I do have a way of charging it. But just in case you go out there with some pipe, and or you find some brass copper, I'm sorry. Copper and some zinc, you probably could charge a battery. All right, I'm going to include, this is a good test, but for survival, woodcrafting, bushcrafting, doomsday prepping, I think it's a downer. I gave it a half a point out of five. Five is the best. Would I use this out in a survival situation? Probably not. But if you're last resort, you can do this. Bushcrafting, like making something out of wood with a little light and having this run forever, good idea. Charging your battery, I don't know. I have to do a test. So, next video, I'm going to try to do and see what happens if I charge a battery. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky, and my camera's been giving me hell, but I'm trying to give you some spatial face looks. This camera's working better than this one. So, let me know what you think about the Earth battery. Did you think it's a fail, or did I do a good job? So, basically, I just made five cells. Oh, you motherfucker. All right. But I believe if I have a solar panel, it would do better than the Earth batteries. Unless my polar cell, my sun cell breaks, then I can use or rely on the battery, Earth batteries. All right, let me let you go. I'm having problems with this. All right, bye-bye, I'm Ranger Kooky. Mama loves you. Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I want to show you this last part of what I'm doing. I'm going to do a test to see if it's going to charge this completely dead battery. I noticed I did some tests before I put the battery on. I did this. So what is this Earth battery good for? It's only good to light a little bitty light, or maybe if I had more cells. I seen the guy had 8 cells and lit up a big old light. I only have 5. Maybe if I had more, I tested each one before I plugged the battery in. See what I did with the battery? I hooked it on there and should be charging, but when I hooked that up and I tested it, it had no electricity, no magic. I don't know if I killed it or what, or when I put these two together, it just killed it. It had zero. Unless all the energy is going into that battery, now it's being charged. This battery is completely dead. I'm gonna leave it like this and see what happens. So, I don't know how long, it might take forever to charge this battery, because it's only 5 cells. Remember, every time you put a copper and zinc right together, that comes a cell. I only got 5, and it was giving me almost 9.4 volts, or whatever you want to call it. It's less than a volt. It's below the volt. I don't know all that technology. I forgot to test lead. I got a big lead pipe thing here. I forgot to do a test, but you know what? It's going right there for now. Just to keep it dry. I've been picking up on my twos. Next video is going to be the can worm, which I think is going to be twice as better than the Earth batteries. I hope you enjoyed that video of the Earth batteries. I tried my best to make the most power. But if I had more copper and more zinc rods, I'd probably have a better charging system. What do you think? Do you think this is good for a bushcrafter? To make maybe like a little artifact with a little light in it, with some dirt in the back, or holds mud and charge the little light? It takes almost 8 cells. 5 cells to light that little bitty one I had. Do you think it'd be good for a survival situation? Maybe charging your batteries. Maybe if I had more cells. I could buy, let's say if I bought and went to Walmart, or Home Depot, and I bought maybe 100 cells. That means I can make 100 cells, put them 100 cups, because you notice on it, I got 1.5 out of those of the clay and sand. Test the sand and clay that you might get a higher juice and see if you can charge a battery. I got an amplifier, but I don't think it's going to even make an amplifier even kick on. I think you have to have so much juice to kick on an amplifier. Now, any of my subscribers or my viewers sees that, hey, you could add such and such to make the boost power up more. Because there is all kinds of little things you can get, like a jewel feast. Jewel thief. It boosts up your energy cell from your batteries and other things in electronics. So if you're in electronics and you know a little bit more about me, which you probably do, give me a howl below. See if I can just use 5 cells. I'm not going to buy no more. That's $30 right there. $30 for them little rods and copper. Trying to get free stuff from now on. I got that lead thing for free. I didn't do any tests yet, but I believe it's going to be in a good range. You got different types of metals you could try. Different types of metal you might be able to try and get your cell to be higher up. So let's find out about this test. And the next thing I'm going to build is the can worm. Can worm has 2 good uses. So I hope it's better than the earth battery. Now the earth battery, like I said, I gave it a half a point. A half a point into survival. I don't think you'd be able to survive with the earth's batteries. Earth batteries are just a hobby. Something to do with somebody just to pass time. Maybe they had more cells that can light up a bigger light. Maybe. But I'm not going to spend no more money. Case closed. Unless you send me some copper and some zinc, which probably none of y'all would do. But I'm trying to find somebody who has extra those pipes tested so I can do my test, and I will give them back. But lucky I got the lead. You say you can have the lead. Thank you. All right. Surviving? No. Maybe. That 1%. I give it a 1% chance. If I had more cells, maybe would charge that battery and charge my battery in the middle of the woods if I don't have a solar panel. Now the solar panel, I tested. It gave me almost 4 volts, point something, so I could charge that battery that's inside. Now if I had, I do got a plate for solar power to charge my batteries. So I don't go dead in the middle of the woods and have heavy batteries to carry around. Mine's a rechargeable, so I don't have to leave them in the woods. All right, bushcrafting using the earth cells. I think there'll be a 5%, not 5% of the first one. Maybe some bushcrafter might find some type of way of building an artifact or some type of layout. Because I've seen somebody did this with fruit tree. Plug little lights into the fruit tree, but it took little bitty dim lights, but it was in the fruit. But this is in dirt, so you might have a little bit more. Oh, I do want to say that will, the earth batteries will charge a calculator, a watch. Anything has little digits, like a watch or a calculator, it will charge that. That'd be into a bushcraft. If you could find something, hey, I want to build something to have a digital clock display, and it's powered by the earth cells behind your craft. Yes, I give it a 5%. Not a 1, not a 2, not a 3, not a 5, none of those numbers. A 5%. A bushcrafter can use the earth cells to make some type of craft. As long as it's some type of digital clock. That'd be kind of cool. Doomsday prepping. Would I use that for doomsday? No. I'll give it a 0 for that. Surviving, I gave it a 5%. Maybe if I could charge that battery I put over there with 5 cells, I don't know how long it will take, but I'm gonna test it every day to see if I got a good charge or any charge. Then I will give you response to that. I gave that 5% out of 1. 1% for surviving. Like I said, my bad. 1% for surviving, 5% for bushcrafting, and doomsday prepping for this, you better have 100 cells. 100 copper rods, 100 zinc rods, then you might have something. You might have some type of light. You can probably charge one of those lights on this. I did have a little... It took a little bit rechargeable battery to turn this on, but it didn't turn on with cells because maybe I didn't have enough cells. But I think if I had 8 cells, it would turn on this light. One. This one would be light. So there you have it. The Earth cell, or yeah, the Earth battery. You see why I gave into the point. It didn't go into a 1 point. It went into percentage. So what you think about this? Do you have some type of technology I can add on to that to give it a boost? Let me know. I want to know if you are going to try this experiment. I tried this experiment for you, so you don't have to. Next experiment is the can worm. What does it do? Watch the next video when I make it. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky. I do believe this video is way too long, about 20, 30 minutes, but I wanted to teach you something. And while showing you everything in detail, you will never learn a squat. So, but I do go to cut and edit all the little things. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I want to say, see you next video.